My feelings would not allow me to speak.
So your feelings are too strong for you now?
Monsieur.
No, no. All you are doing, my lord, is toying with the emotions of an impressionable young lady.
Miss Edwina seems perfectly capable of forming her own impressions. Perhaps if you took notice.
So now you claim to know my sister better than me.
I know she wishes to be happy.
This is precisely what I wish for her. I can assure you, happiness is not your strength. Exasperation, perhaps, fixation, most definitely. The only feeling you are in fact capable of engendering, my lord, is that of discontent. Do not tell me
what to do! No, stand still, damn it! No, do not do
this. This is only a beat. Ow!
Are you hurt?
What?
Can you breathe?
It is only a sting, of course.
Are you certain?
My lord.
No. Do not.
My lord. Do not. I am unharmed.
Have I done something to you? Why is it that you dislike me so?
Because you vex me!
And what is it do you think you do to me?
What? What do I do to you?
You. You hate me.
I do. I hate you.
I am a gentleman.
And your heart is with my sister.
And my heart is with your sister. Say you do not care for me. Tell me you feel nothing, and I will walk away.
I feel.
Sharma. Miss Sharma.
Lord Bridgerton.
Welcome in refreshment. Is it not, Bridgerton?
Refreshing indeed. Come now, it is not proper to stare. Why? And do not talk to me of dowry, sir. For we both know you have no need of it. So tell me, what has she done?
She has done nothing, it is you. You have made this match impossible.
But I am leaving for India.
And it is not far enough. Do you think that there is a corner of this earth that you could travel to far away enough free me from this torment. I am a gentleman. My father raised me to act with honor, but that honor is hanging by a thread that grows more precarious with every moment I spend in your presence. You are the bane of my existence. And the object of all my desires. Night and day, I dream of you. And what I... Do you even know all the ways a lady can be seduced? The things I could teach you?
I did not ask for this. To be plagued by these feelings. Hiding from my sister. Being driven to distraction every time you entered the room.
And you agree? It is insupportable.
My lord.
The Archbishop would like you to repeat, my lord, after him.
Yes, of course.
I, Lord Anthony Bridgerton.
Rami.
Lord Bridgerton.
Your sister is braver and wiser than us both. She had the courage to act on what she sensed between us, and here we are, standing perfectly still, having felt it for months.
I stand here because the moment we step foot outside those doors, we face the truth.
Of our situation.
Of our failures. We have indeed failed, my lord. Of our duties. Of our responsibilities. We have failed at it all. So forgive me if it is now my wish to suspend time, to delay the inevitable, to for a mere moment not to think of what comes next. To wait. Goodbye, my lord.
It is maddening how much you consume my very being. My family is on the brink of ruin. I am nearly certain every last one of my brothers and sisters secretly despise me, my own mother at that, despite the fact I've lived the better part of my life for them. And yet still, all I find myself thinking about, all I find myself being able to breathe for, is you. Do you think that I want to be in this position? Contending with these thoughts of wanting to be nowhere except with you. Wanting to run away with you. Of acting on the most impure, forbidden desires, no matter how how much I must remind myself. I am a gentleman, and you are a lady of that scent. Mm. It has remained imprinted on my mind ever since the night of the conservatory ball on that terrace. I love you. I've loved you from the moment we raced each other in that park. I've loved you at every dance, on every walk, every time we've been together, and every time we've been apart. You do not have to accept it, you do not have to embrace it, or even allow it. Knowing you, you probably will not, but you must know it in your heart. You must feel it, because I do. I love you.
I do not know what to say.
You do not have to say anything.
I do not think there is anything else to say. Other than I love you too.
I want a life that suits us both. I know I am imperfect, but I will humble myself before you because I cannot imagine my life without you, and that is why I wish to marry you.
You do know there'll never be a day where you do not vex me.
Is that a promise, Kanthony Sharma?
Yes. Yes, it is a promise.
Well, then. It seems the two of us are finally seeing eye to eye on something.
I suppose we are.